listen, 5 months before he got stopped by David Haye, he knocked out a guy, Ty Fields, 6'8". So I don't think height's an issue.
OK, Alexander Ustinov, Monty Barrett, the commentary team, Jim Watt and Adam Smith.
Thank you, Dave. An important, interesting clash here. Two contrasting heavyweights lying slightly below world title level, but with a big opportunity to become part of the scene. The Belarusian Alexander Ustinov, the huge 21-stone man, very much the fighter on the ascendancy, seeking out his 19th win against the well-travelled one-time hope and still useful American Monty Barrett. It's a classic sort of crossroads confrontation, this, Jim.
Yeah, well, Barrett, I mean, a proven decent fighter over the years, maybe just reaching the stage where he's just making up the numbers, just maybe making a living coming towards the end of his career. They can still be dangerous, still not. He's just been...
Beautiful right hand from Ustinov, and down goes Barrett. There's the power of the Belarusian, who's got 15 knockouts in his 18 wins. Barrett says he's okay. He's been stopped a couple of times early recently. Mickey Van takes the count. The referee from Leeds, who can officiate here, and Ustinov going for a quick fire win.
See, the punch landed high in the top of Barrett's head, and sometimes that's the kind of punches it takes a long time to shake the effects. I think he's still a little bit stunned, his feet are unsteady. I mean, he's just been bundled to the floor there, no count. He's just kind of bundled over, but I don't think his head has cleared.
Disorientated Monty Barrett, and a 5-stone weight advantage for Ustinov. Barrett back with the right hand.
He's clinging up close, just trying to buy a little bit of time to get his head cleared. But really forced onto the defensive. Ustinov very mobile considering the size, and you can see he got full power into that shot. Hasn't managed to repeat it as yet. That's down to the experience of Barrett.
He's 38 now, Barrett. Punch resistance might not be what it once was. Has he shaken the effects of that off? Dramatic early action with these heavyweights tonight.
Well, Ustinov just maybe a little bit too keen to land the same punch again. Maybe wants to settle down, try and open Barrett up with the jab. Barrett just trying to survive this round. Just ducking, diving, grabbing when he's up close. Coming back with a jab of his own.
He calls himself two guns, Monty Barrett. He's trying to find the heavy hooks from somewhere to catch Ustinov. Just over 30 seconds left of the first round. Really reaching with that, Barrett.
Well, the strength seems to be back in the legs. He seems to have thrown the effects of it. But a tremendous difference in weight. And, a huge task in more ways than one for Barrett. Good right hand, though. He's getting his own punches off now.
A decent comeback from that horrible start for Monty Barrett. He's clawed his way through this first round. Just about. It was a strange one, didn't think he'd recover from it, but he did.
Not that the punch seemed to land pretty high on his head and it scrambled his senses, but he's a very experienced man, so he knows what to do. Okay, he just did anything he could do to survive, just to buy some time to get his head cleared. He managed to do that, and he was getting some decent punches of his own off towards the end of the opening round. But a disastrous start, 10-8 round straight away to Ustinov. And Barrett knows this big fella has the power.
So in and out, keep your defense tight, and don't wait for that right hand. All right? Let's get focused and make this work. Clean it up. Back to the game plan. Stick to the game plan.
Hands up, baby. Second of 12. Decent heavyweight meeting here between the 33-year-old Alexander Ustinov from Minsk in Belarus and Monty Barrett, the New Yorker now living in Jersey. and the red trunks. In real trouble at the start of this, Barrett. He's always in exciting, woolly affairs, isn't he?
Yeah, but I think it just showed that what he's learned over the years in the opening round, getting through the opening round. A lot of fighters wouldn't have managed to do that, but survival instincts kicked in, and he's still there.
So much experience, Barrett. Been in with the likes of Vladimir Klitschko and Nikolai Valuev. David Hay last year. Swinging. Trying to test the chin of Ustinov. He's had a solid rise.
He's able now to make an argument of it, Barrett. And there's the speed and the movement that can cause Ustinov a few problems. Ustinov's still a little bit too keen to land the big guns again.
Ustinov outpointed Michael Sprott in June, over 10 rounds. Sprott always useful and good that night. Barrett trying to exchange, head cleared. Getting his upper body moving again. He told me, Jim, this week he's trained really, really hard for this, Monty Barrett. He sees it as a bit of a last chance.
Yeah, I think that's fair comment. I think a third loss on the spin would be difficult to come back from. But he's always looked upon as a respected opponent. So he'll always make a living, but if he hopes maybe to make an impact, then a win tonight would be a huge result for him. Becoming a little bit untidy now.
He's stretching there, Ustinov. Not finding the range. Barrett more fleet-footed. Ustinov, who promises he would show his skills and his speed, even though he's over 20 stone.
Вот он делает первый шаг, а потом сразу вперед.
Vladimir Petrin in the corner of Team Ustinov. Alexander the Great.
Maybe a slight exaggeration. He had trouble pinning Barrett down in the second round, but he knows he has the power. One shot had him all over the place in the opening round, but not been able to repeat that shot since.
Ustinov unbeaten since his professional debut back in May 2005. Monty Barrett's lost 8 times, mostly at a high level. Coming off a 2-round demolition, unfortunately for him, to Adlania Solis, who was highly rated as a new heavyweight force. Good jab there from Ustinov, who's got natural power behind the big frame. Just clumsy sometimes with his charges, isn't he, Ustinov?
Yeah, but I think some clever defensive moves from Barrett. Trying the big right hand. Just wonder what would happen if he could land cleanly with one of those big right swings, Barrett. You see, I mean, there's a huge weight difference. But if you can test Ustinov's chin, it hasn't been tested too often, so who knows?
Has got 20 knockout wins, Monty Barrett, through the years. Once upon a time, he was a college football player. Grew up in the New York gyms, learnt, developed, and he's capable.
I just think the problem, every time they come close, Barrett just has to spoil. Obviously, he can't compete up close. A good left hand from Ustinov again.
Really launched everything into that massive right, Monty Barrett.
Yeah, but missing by a mile, I'm afraid.
And will he have the stamina of old? Can't spend energy like that, get away with it, especially with this weight difference.
See, I think that is the problem. That's why the action is so untidy. As soon as they get close, Barrett has to go into survival mode, spoil a little bit up close. So any damage you can inflict, it has to do it at full range. See, again, up close, grabbing hold of Ustinov's left arm.
Trying to show his athleticism and movement, Ustinov. Jumped into the ring off the top rope. It's quite impressive. But difficult with the size and bulk.
Well, Ustinov trying to show a cooler head now. Not being so obvious and looking for the big right hand. Oh, he launched it there.
It's untidy at the end of that one.
And that's part B. Keep him making mistakes. All right? Put some on that eyelid, Vic. I don't want you getting hit with no unnecessary punches. All right? Keep your defense up and touch them close. Bang, bang. Then step over to your right. Let's get it going.
Cool.
All right? Yeah. Tight defense. Come on, baby. Come on.
He's going to. They're a tight-knit team. Andre Rosier, Victor Roundtree with two guns. Monty Barrett. Well, he survived the first. Monty Barrett, he's still there. The jerky style. Attempting to befuddle, confuse Alexander Ustinov. But Ustinov taking these rounds, Jim.
Yeah, Barrett's missing wildly with the punches, but he's managing to claim the centre of the ring quite often. The trouble is, when it gets close, he just has to employ the kind of spoiling tactics. He can't cope up close with a massive weight difference. I would just love to see one of these big right hands landing on Ustinov's chin, just to see what effect it would have.
Mickey Van from Leeds just sorting out the advertising hoardings. As we were saying earlier, he can't officiate in Britain anymore because he passed his 65th birthday. But he's still dancing and gliding around the ring. He is allowed to referee in Europe. Looking for the big right. Monty Barrett. There is a target there, isn't there?
Yeah, this is good stuff at the moment from Barrett. He's getting his punches off quickly.
Walked into that one though. From Ustinov. Just lurches forward.
It's really a wild right hand that Barrett's throwing at times, just a big hopeful swing.
Been good value down the years though, Monty Barrett. Started boxing till he was 22. Ustinov, another late starter, turned pro at 28.
Couple of good shots, little feint there from Ustinov. That's what you have to do with Barrett. Little feint, try and force him into making the first move, kind of thumping inside of the glove shot there from Ustinov.
And there's the strength of Ustinov. That's got to be tough for Barrett.
Yeah, now these jobs usually, the longer they go, the tougher it becomes. Barrett started the round quite well, but hasn't really made an impression since. Just lunging in with hopeful punches again there.
Maybe the plan is to try and outlast Ustinov, take him into deep waters. But will Barrett have the fitness to be able to do that at 38.
Ustinov just throwing some nice little one-twos, just keeping it simple now.
The corner of the 33-year-old Alexander Ustinov, born in Russia, lives now in Minsk, Belarus. Quietly effective last couple of rounds.
Yeah, he's kept it simple. He's showing a cooler head now. He was going for the knockout, obviously, in the second round after, you know, the big bomb that landed in the opening round. But a cooler head, just little simple one-twos. But can't always pin Barrett down.
The black trunks of Alexander Ustinov, who stands about 6'7 and a half. Monty Barrett, 6'3 in the red, the American. We've seen plenty of over the years. Ustinov looking for his 19th win. Used to be a kickboxer. He's in Muay Thai and on the K1 circuit. How's he adapted?
Yeah, but I think he's adapted well. You know, he's pretty mobile considering the size and weight. Barrett, to his credit, claiming the centre of the ring here, pushing the big man back, but not really getting close enough to get any real punches off, and that right hand he's throwing is still a little bit wild.
You're telegraphing it. Plenty of skills he had earlier on in his career, Monty Barrett. Good friends with Zam Judah, Shannon Briggs and Dimitri Salita. Couldn't bring himself to watch a replay of the Khan-Salita fight. That's how close he is. A tight group, the New York boys. Can he breathe fire back into his career late on, Barrett?
Well, again, Barrett claiming the centre of the ring, forcing the big man to circle, but just can't get close enough to get any decent punches off.
A right hand from Ustinov. Barrett fires one back, but just open and caught. And Ustinov boxing well here.
Yeah, he's showing a little bit of technique, Ustinov. He's picking his moments. Not as wild as he was a couple of rounds earlier. He realises this man's difficult to catch cleanly. So he is boxing quite well at the moment, Ustinov.
Right back from Barrett. Still having the occasional say. Ustinov in control. And look at him leaning all over the lighter man.
Yeah, just trying to drain the energy as they get up close there.
He went 10 rounds in June against Michael Sprott. Barrett's had short, quick fights in the last two and a half years. It'll take Nikolai Valov 11 rounds to catch up with him, but that was over 3 years ago. Might not have the resistance and stamina to get through 12 here, Barrett.
He's still able to frustrate and annoy the big man here, but not scoring with enough punches to put forward a case for himself.
Just breathing heavier now. Monty Barrett. Could be getting tough for him.
Yeah, well, he was pulling a face as he walked back to the corner at the end of the previous round there, as though this was becoming a little bit tough for him. But still frustrating, Ustinov. Still trying with that hopeful right hand now and again.
43rd fight in the 13-year pro career of Monty Barrett. And the 19th for Alexander Ustinov. Still hasn't tasted defeat yet, the Belarusian. Ranked about 6 now in the WBA, so champion David Hay, of course, will be watching this with interest. Anything to worry about for Hay with Ustinov, do you think?
No, but I mean, if he's struggling to land cleanly on Barrett, as he is at the moment, then I don't think he's quite in David Hay's league. But he is big. is huge actually, and pretty mobile. And there's probably still a bit of improvement to be seen in his work. Only his 19th fight, remember.
Hay dealt with Barrett in 5 last year. Of course, he dealt with that 7-stone weight disadvantage against Nikolai Balaev. So he might fancy a match against Usinov, David Hay down the line. What a win this first, though, the Belarusian. Taking the round, surely. But Barrett still in there.
Barrett's jabs landing short here, just not able really to make an impression.
Nicky Van looks so small in there as he tries to split them. Been pretty clean.
Yeah, well, not so much spoiling in the last couple of rounds. Barrett not maybe been allowed to get up close.
Not quite as much coming from Usinov in this session. The range finding jab.
Barrett walking on to the odd left jab now. He's maybe just slowing down a little bit as well.
Coming rather more flat-footed as this contest ticks along. Monty Barrett. That's good movement from Ustinov.
Yeah, but he's got his jab working nicely too.
Keep that shit straight. Straight! Right down the middle. Stop reaching for it. Forget that.
Trying to motivate Monty Barrett in the blue corner near us. Jovial guy out of the ring, Alexander Usinov. Second half, 12 round affair, heavyweight division. Of course, I think you can tell that from the size of Alexander Usinov.
Yeah, that's for sure. He is massive. But look at Barrett again, able to come out and claim the centre of the ring. Just if he was a little bit sharper with his punching, he just can't time his punches enough to make a real impression on this big fellow.
Weighed in at 21 stone, 3.5 to Barrett, 16-3. The American in dire straits in the first round. Stuck in. Trying to get the jab going. Can he make a dent on Usinov?
Well, a positive start to this round from Barrett, getting his jabs off. Not allowing Usinov to set anything up. Good work now. He's caused Usinov to miss with a lot of punches over the rounds. So wonder, good jab from Barrett. Wonder maybe if the tiredness pulling that huge frame around the ring for the 6 rounds.
Barrett's lost 5 of his last 8. So really needs a big win. Uppercut from Usinov. And again, when the hands come down of Barrett, he looks all at sea. Just falling in there, Jim Barrett.
Yeah, a good start to the round. It was back in Ustinov up, but he hasn't been able to sustain it. But saying that, he hasn't allowed Ustinov to land too many clean shots either. But you just get the feeling this is taking everything out of him just to hang on in this fight. Huge task for him. Ustinov not all that impressive in this round.
So many natural advantages with Ustinov, and Barrett just pulls away there. And that's given the big Belarusian a boost, a lift. Lost 10 seconds of the seven.
I thought their arms were locked here, and I think maybe injured Barrett's shoulder. I think Ustinov threw a punch but kind of twisted his shoulder. Yeah, I wonder. He's not looking too happy in the corner, Barrett.
Left arm, left shoulder. What's happened? Successful around for Ustinov, but is there an injury to Monty Barrett?
Yeah, I just got the feeling that his shoulder was wrenched. I saw Ustinov throwing the punch and he seemed to the arms get tangled a little bit, but they're getting Barrett ready for the next round, so I don't think there's any question of him being pulled out of there.
And at a time where he's just starting to find a little form.
Then wake up, come on, wake up, goddammit!
Slow out of his corner, Monty Barrett. And his team is trying to lift him. Alexander Ustinov will be in a handy lead on the guards of the three judges. But Barrett, well, he had a decent last round.
Yep, especially the first minute and a half, 2 minutes of the round, walked onto a jab there, Barrett.
Far more experienced than Ustinov, over double the fights. Can he push Ustinov? Test his stamina. A good punch by Barrett. So difficult for him to flow, Monty Barrett.
Yeah, and it's just getting tougher, obviously, with every round that passes. We're not seeing the big right hands that he's throwing earlier there. He's just tried to launch one, as I was saying that there. But no snap on those shots now. I just think the job is becoming too big for him. Having said that, Ustinov's work not as clean and sharp as it was earlier.
With a jab again, Monty Barrett having some success at getting through, but it must be grueling for him.
Ustinov breathing with his mouth open there as well, he's feeling it.
Blood to the nose too, Jim, of Ustinov. And I wonder if that game plan, cooked up by the Americans, was just to try and stay in there with Ustinov, take him to a place he won't be comfortable.
Well, dragging that huge bulk about, causing him to miss with so many punches in the earlier rounds. But the trouble is trying to make an impression on him. That's the difficult thing for Barrett. Another decent round from Barrett, giving as good as he's getting in this round.
So tough to outlast a 20 stone plus man. He's still fairly mobile, but Barrett giving this a real go and improving. Right hand from Ustinov. But is he giving that round away?
Yep, Barrett again claiming the centre of the ring, pushing the big man back.
And don't follow him.
Exactly.
Take your shit off and do not follow him.
You're not
coming a little bit to you.
If you're tired, suck it up, because he is too. But you got to utilize the weapons we ask you to.
And don't follow him.
Don't reach for him. Start banging him with that right hand in the solar plexus.
You get your shit off, step back, make a miss, counter.
Don't say all right and you're not following through.
Let's do it.
Come on.
Has Monty Barrett got enough left in the tank? Didn't look like it on the stool there. But how much has Alexander Usinov have left as well?
Well,
both tiring.
Yeah, Barrett's competed well in the last couple of rounds, but I wonder if it's just emptied the tank. He didn't look all that happy, all that keen to start the next round.
Red trunks of Monty Barrett, born in North Carolina, living in Jersey now. And Alexander Usinov in those black shorts.
Getting the jab off nice and sharp there at the beginning of the round here, Barrett.
Big right. Clumping punch from Usinov. Complaining there, Monty Barrett is. There a danger he may fall apart under this sort of, you know, grueling hard pressure.
Well, he certainly hasn't looked all that happy in between rounds in the corner. But the good old pro, the good old soldier that he is, he gets up. Gets himself back to work again. That's me, he's doing that again.
And that jab still troubling Usinov. And a right hand from Barrett. Not the finished article, Alexander Usinov, is he, by any stretch of the imagination?
And obvious signs he's tiring as well. He's been caught more cleanly with punches.
Snapping out the right hand, the latest colossus from Eastern Europe. They breed them big these days. But does big mean good?
He's never been able to subdue Barrett. Yeah, good right hand body shot too from Usinov. Barrett again complaining to the referee, which is never a good sign.
They're slumping down Barrett and holding the big waist of Usinov whenever he has a chance. Draining. Then deflating, it must be. It's a game effort, though.
Yeah, it's another round where Barrett hasn't really allowed Usinov to land that many clean shots. I mean, the action's a little bit scrappy now.
Come on, baby. Come on, man. God damn, baby. Listen.
I think he said something about his right hand there.
Yeah, well, in the early part of the round, Barrett got the jab working, but you get the impression he's really struggling to keep the ambition to keep him in here.
Down, up, hook to the body with your jab. You know what I'm saying? That ain't nothing but a thing. You just fucking fight.
Excuse the language in the corner.
That's why you heard it. All right, let's keep it clean now. This dude is really nowhere near in your class.
He's not, baby, Bob.
You're making him look better than he is. We were supposed to walk out the house with this victory. Now let's get on that jab and keep it popping.
Move your head. Move your head. What's the jab?
Don't
down,
drop
up,
your defense.
Hooks. Bring move this. Your head.
Come on. Right,
keep it right.
Really fascinating insight there. It's as if they all know that a sort of younger Monty Barrett would have the class to deal with this big guy Usinov, but now timing, maybe not.
Yeah, he just can't turn the clock back. He knows how to go about the job. And he has done well. And again, look, he comes out again and claims the centre of the ring. He knows exactly what's required. Just sustaining it's a problem against such a big man at this stage in his career. Ustinov's jabs working well at the start of this round.
Just down he goes. Monty Barrett collapses in a heap there. Says there's a punch maybe back of the head, but these aren't good signs.
No, I thought a jab kind of landed. It didn't land full force. But the signs are that Barrett may be just losing the desire to hang on in there. I think maybe a boost when he went back to the corner would have done him more good than maybe the criticism that the corner were giving him, telling him he wasn't doing enough. Maybe a little pat in the back would have worked a little bit better.
In with the shoulder there, Usinov.
See, he's shown the signs to Usinov that he's not all that keen, and that'll give him a little bit more ambition.
Blood to the nose of Barrett. That can't help his breathing. We've got a crucial stage of this 12th rounder. Still snapping the jab out. It's a shame, really, that Monty Barrett hasn't gone on to win a big title of some sort, because I think there is ability. There's always been ability.
Yeah, well, he's certainly learned the business, and he's learned the business the hard way. And it's full credit. I mean, the way so often he's claimed the centre of the ring, forced this fellow onto the back foot. But just as I say, you can't turn the clock back.
Maybe just falling short on the big nights too. He gave Vladimir Klitschko a tough fight in London. But was eventually beaten. Same against Nikolai Valuev. And decked a number of times by David Haye.
Yeah, but he's just not producing any quality work at all in this round, Barrett. This round, a struggle up close. You can see he's trying to hang there. Just buy a little bit of time.
I don't think his body language will be very good back on the stool at the end of this round. Still two more to go. And Usinov has picked up the pace and is looking better again.
Yeah, I think the paces that Barrett's been pulling, the fact he went onto the floor, didn't look as though he wanted to continue, has given Usinov a boost. And he's raised his pace a little bit.
Good round for Usinov. And a deflated looking Barrett.
You all right?
I mean, you can see Ustinov looking at the target before he lets the punches go. I mean, that wasn't a punch. I mean, Barrett would never look at that. I mean, you can see he was kind of bundled onto the floor. And that really scrappy stuff.
Probably feeling the pace too, Alexander Usinov. They're trying to fire him up over in that red corner. Has been 10 rounds against Michael Sprott, but not further.
All right, let's go, baby. Let's work here. You got it in you?
And this is now uncharted territory for Alexander Ustinov. Another tick in the box if he's to go 12 rounds. Handy lead, Jim. Can you see him throwing it away?
No, I'd be surprised. I thought Barrett had a couple of decent rounds. the halfway stage, just after the halfway stage. But it didn't really produce anything in the last round there. But again, trying to claim the centre of the ring. I mean, full credit to Monty Barrett. I mean, the size of this job and the way he's gone about it, when at times you feel his heart's not really in it. What a good throw.
And he has been troubling Usinov with the jab. Is that a fault of the Belarusians? Is that something he's got to address, his head movement?
Yeah, well, I mean, you don't expect the size and the weight he is. I mean, you can't expect razor-sharp reflexes. And Monty Barrett, very experienced and a class fighter, remember. Just coming to the end of his career. But still, lots of room for improvement in Ustinov, obviously.
The body shot, Ustinov. He's lighter on his feet than, say, Nikolai Valuev, isn't he?
Yeah, he is pretty mobile, and you can see he's showing little feints before he throws. There he goes again. Leading with the right hand there. Yeah, I mean, there's a bit of technique in what he's doing.
Looked like he was on course for an early blowout, Usinov. Barrett's done ever so well to hang in there and have his success too. Judges at ringside from Denmark, Germany and Spain. I'm sure Barrett hasn't won too many of these.
Not that around when he's totally...
Just having a rest now, Jim.
Yeah, I think he's really looking forward to the final bell. I mean, there have been rounds where he's completely frustrated at Ustinov, but maybe not producing enough work to win the rounds, but making his point nonetheless. They're trying to get the jab off now.
Quite the moves of old Monty Barrett, and that's part of the problem.
Not a great round, that one.
Listen to me. How you feel?
I feel okay. I just can't throw my right hand.
He's saying he can't throw his right hand. There is a problem.
Yeah, just one of the many problems. That's when he was pushed onto the ropes and he was quite happy. I think he'd have been quite happy to sit there for the rest of the round. Done well to hang on in here.
You're getting with the house of pain. Take care of this round. Nice and sharp. Box. I don't want to see you fight. I want to see you box. You hear me? Dictate with the jab and win this round with the jab for me. And I'll be very happy. Okay? You got that for me? Box. Don't get hit. Get box. Let's keep that jab. Box. Back with your jab. Once you go low with your jab, you can't do nothing with it. Big round, baby. Come on. Wake it up. All right?
Well, it's as if he's only going out for the sixth or seventh. They know defeat is on the cards. They just want him to hear the final bell and go out with his head held high and back to Sun Brandon in the States tomorrow morning.
Yeah, and I think he's entitled to do that. I think he's put up a tremendous show here tonight.
Well, he's a long way in front, Usinov.
Yeah, well, I have him 7 points up there, 108, 101. A nice little spell in the middle from Barrett, but couldn't sustain it. A lot of scrappy rounds that you could have given him the benefit of the doubt, maybe even scored them level, but there's no way you can have Barrett winning this, and I think his own corner realised that, the way they were speaking to him, just want him to go out on his shield in a flurry in the last round.
From the big swing himself, Usinov. What have you thought about him tonight? He'll surely be unbeaten in 19, he's 33. Is he going to get amongst the title picture next year? What do you think?
Well, there's certainly room for improvement, but having said that, I mean, there's something to work with here. He's very mobile considering the size. I don't think he has tremendous punching power, but it's difficult to gauge his punching power against Barrett. who's very experienced and not all that easy to catch cleanly, apart from the opening round when it was caught a little bit cold. I mean, it's not too often Ustinov has landed flush with full power shots, so we haven't really seen tonight what kind of power he carries. We know he has a good knockout percentage, but at what level?
Ustinov has wins over Julius Long, Michael Sprott, Cedric Fields. This would be the biggest so far. And a good end to the year. Nice right hand, clips on Barrett's chin.
That was a lovely right hand. Barrett's taken it well at this stage in the fight.
Well, he told us he worked hard for it. He trained doggedly for weeks, had good notice. And that's why I think that he's got through the 12 rounds.
Yeah, there's no question he is in great shape.
Now I think he wants to lie down there till the final bell.
That was clever, huh? You know, putting his arms up for Mickey Van to pull him back on his feet again. Clever.
Likeable old pro, Monty Barrett. But just not enough left at this stage. It was a monumental ask, really, against Alexander Ustinov. He's done well to finish at a decent pace too.
Yeah, he's shown that he's still tricky. He still knows his way around the ring. But just too many rounds when he didn't produce enough, he was missing badly himself. But he can be proud of his showing.
Shake of the head from Monty Barrett. Got through the 12 rounds. Complaining about the right hand. And that left shoulder's not too good either. Bumps and bruises.
Yep, continued to frustrate Ustinov all night long. But as I say, too many rounds and he wasn't quite producing enough punches to win the rounds. And I think he realises that himself. But admirable showing. And just seeing how many times he frustrated the big man. And I thought he may have taken a lot longer to get back on his feet than he did there. But he got up sharply and back to business again.
Do you think Team Ustinov will be happy with their man tonight?
Well, I think they'll be happy that they've seen him do a lively 12 rounds. It's nice to get a 12 round under your belt. At least you know you can do that. And it was a lively pace all the way through. He missed with a lot of punches himself. But he finished it strong, fit. So they'll at least be pleased with that. They would obviously have liked the knockout. But yeah, I think they'll be reasonably pleased that he has that 12 rounder under his belt.
Wonder how much we'll see more of Monty Barrett in a ring. Ustinov just completing his sixth fight of 2009. I'm sure we'll be looking forward to a rest over the Christmas period. Nothing official yet. Mickey Van smiles. And we just wait for the cards to be totted up. Surely Ustinov will remain undefeated.
Well, there were times during the fight when you thought Barrett was losing his enthusiasm, maybe he wasn't going to be able to hang on in there. But full credit to him, great old soldier, great old pro, hung in there, posed all sorts of problems for Ustinov throughout the 12 rounder. But the Ustinov corner confident of victory.
I think we're almost ready to get the official verdict. Respect and smiles all round.
Hier, meine sehr verehrten Damen und Herren, liebe Gäste in der PostFinance Arena in Bern, das Urteil im Kampf um den WBA International Championship Title. José Martinez wertet den Kampf 118 zu 109. Torben Seemann wertet den Kampf 116 zu 112. Und Ringrichter Manfred Küchler aus Deutschland wertet den Kampf 117 zu 110. Ein einstimmiges Punkturteil. damit alter und neuer WBA International Champion aus Minsk, Alexander Ustinov.
Wide and unanimous, Alexander Ustinov makes it 19 straight wins and probably his best result yet.
Yeah, unbeaten record remains intact. 19 straight wins for Alexander Ustinov. Reaction from Johnny Nelson and from Glenn McCrory on the way as a big man celebrates a big victory.